Welcome to the second bonus lecture tutorial for the Arduino programming using assembly, where we are going to implement half adder and subtractor on an Arduino board. So let's start with the first line of this program, which will implement half adder and subtractor on the Arduino board. So the first line says that we are including an m328pdev.inc file, which will contain the pin mapping of the microcontroller Atmega328P. Moving on to the next line, we are storing values of all zeros on the 8 bits in register R16 to configure the inputs A and B on the ports 12 and 13 here and putting it in the port B. Similarly, for the output on port D, we are going to configure the second, third and fourth bit of the port D. Second, third and fourth bit of the port D. Now we'll write the command in R16 and pin B. So pin B, as we know, that takes the input from the pins of port B. So this pin B register will store the inputs from 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 and 13 pins of port B and will be stored in the register R16 here. Now, since we are required to take only A and B inputs from pin B, which is stored in R16, we are going to perform an AND operation on R16 and mask those two values corresponding to A and B here. Now, we'll separate out our input A and store it into register R17. So first we will copy the values of R16 which we have obtained here and store it into R17. Then performing a similar masking operation using AND operator, we'll obtain the A here. And then in order to get the A input on the least significant bit, we'll perform 4 times the right shift operations in order to get A here on the least significant bit. Similarly, to isolate the input B, we copy R16 into R18 first, then performing masking operation using AND gate, we obtain the AND input. And in order to get the AND input on the least significant bit of R18, we perform right shift operations 5 times in order to get the B input on the least significant bit. Having done that, now we move on to copying the value of input A obtained here and storing it into another register R19 and performing an XOR operation. The XOR operation is basically performed between the inputs B and A to signify the sum or the difference, as can be seen here. So using truth table, we can identify that the sum or difference for half adder is equivalent to operation of A XOR B here and storing it into R19 register. Performing XOR operation between R19 and R18 will result into storing the values of the operation in R19 itself. The R19 previously contained the value of A obtained from the R17 register. Now we'll copy the value of R17 into R20 first, and then perform an AND operation for the carry output, which is obtained from the truth table by performing an AND operation between A and B inputs. So since the R20 previously contained input A and R18 contains B, will perform AND operation between R20 and R18, resulting into the AND operation output being stored in R20 itself. Now in order to shift it to second least significant bit, will perform a left shift operation as here. We are doing this so that we can get our output in this form in which we are going to output it on port B. You will understand more after the complete program. Now we'll load 1 in R21 register. As you know that performing an XOR operation between an input and another input being 1 will always result into the complement of the first input. Therefore we are going to perform an XOR operation on the A register, which is stored in R17, with 1 here, and this will result into A AND the complement of A being stored in R21 register. Now we also need to store this R21 AND with R18 into R21. So we'll perform an AND operation between R21, the complement of A, and R18, the B value, for calculating the borrow output. The borrow output obtained from the truth table will result into this expression, which resembles complement of A and an AND operation with B. Now in order to get it in the format for output on port D, we will left shift the borrow output first 1 times, then to move it to the third least significant bit, again the left shift operation is performed. Now we have 3 separate outputs. One is stored in R19, the other one is in R20, and the third one is in R21. Now we will need to perform OR operations between all these 3 outputs. So we'll start with performing an OR operation between R19 register, which contains the sum or the difference from this operation, and R20, which contains the carry output from this operation. And so after this operation we'll get the output as this. Moving on, we'll perform OR operation with the R19. R19 will now look like this value or this value, and we will OR this with R21, which contains the output borrow, and after this operation the output stored in R19 will look like this or this. Since we have done this, now in order to output it from the second, third and fourth pin, we need to shift these values left two times, first here and then second here, so that the values correspond to this format. Having done that, we'll now perform a masking operation with this register stored in R26 in order to get only the values of borrow, carry and sum, and making all the other bits zero and storing it again in R19. Now we will output this register R19 on port D so that we can see it on the second, third and fourth digital pins on the Arduino board. Next, after this statement, it will follow a relative jump last from this 52 number line, as can be seen from here, to 8 number line till here, and it will continue to operate infinite times in a loop format. So now we will move on to the hardware implementation of adder and subtractor, which will give us insight into how this program is working on the hardware. That's it for the software part. And before that, we would also want this program to be compiled first and then uploaded to the Arduino board, so that the Arduino contains the program and then we can move on to making the connections as per this definition we have defined earlier in the program itself. That's it for. So now we'll implement half adder and half subtractor circuits using assembly programming on an Arduino board. The connection has already been done, but just to recap it, I'll start with connecting the 5 volts from the Arduino to the breadboard here, the ground from the Arduino to the breadboard here, and in order to extend this ground, I have connected this black cable and connected it here on the breadboard for connection to the this row. Similarly, for extended this 5 volt, I have connected this orange cable here and extended it for supply to the inputs. Now, this LED, the first LED on the right side, represent the sum or the difference. The second LED, this LED, represents the carry obtained from the half adder operation. And this operation, this LED, resembles the operation of borrow obtained from the half subtractor operation. We have implemented half adder and subtractor in a single circuit because sum or difference has the same logic, so they are being represented by the same LED here on the first, on the right side. Now the black cable represents the input B, the yellow cable represents the input A. So as you can see here, the input B is connected to 0 volt supply here and the input A is connected to 5 volt supply here. So the result should be like this, that the difference obtained from them or the sum obtained from them, the inputs 0 and 1, 0 being B and A being 1, should be 1 for the sum or difference, and the borrow should be 1 high. So we can see that the first LED on the right side and the last LED on from the right side are glowing, representing the sum to be 1 or the difference to be 1 and the borrow to be 1. The carry in this case is 0, as adding 0 and 1 will always result in 1 and there will be 0 carry. If we change this input, making B to be 1 this time and making A to be 0, we can see here that the sum or difference LED has started glowing and the carry or even the borrow LEDs are off in this case. So now we'll change the inputs to 1 and 1. So now we can see that adding 1 and 1 will result into 0 sum and the carry will be 1. So we can see that the second LED here is seen to be glowing, as can be seen from here. There is a dim brightness here, and in this case the sum LED is not glowing at all. The borrow LED is also 0 because there won't be any borrow as the inputs are same. Now we'll change this inputs to making it all zeros. Now we can see that the all LEDs have turned off, meaning that adding 0 and 0 will result into 0 sum or difference, 0 carry and 0 borrow. So this is how we implement a half adder or subtractor using an Arduino board, programming it using assembly programming and representing it using the LEDs here. We have already done the coding part in assembly on the system itself. Thank you.